Look at me. Look at me right here. The power of God is going to fall in this place. Those of you that need the Holy Spirit, look at me right now. Look at me. Right here. Look at me. Look at me. You're going to get the Holy Ghost. You're going to receive the Holy Spirit. It's going to happen. It's got the power of God. Look at me. I'm honest. But you're going to feel the English. You're going to feel the power of God. You'll feel it. You'll feel the power of your great things happen. You're going to feel the power of God's superstorm. What we've got to do, here's what's going to happen. We have to get our hearts ready to receive from God. And here's what we do. Listen to me carefully. Do not beg God. Believe God. Begging is the opposite of believing. God already has promised to give me forgiveness. Promised to give me the baptism of the Holy Spirit. I do not need to beg Him. I just need to believe Him. Amen? So here's what's going to happen. In just a moment, I'm going to make a call to repent. To repent is to know Jesus died in your place for your sins. But not just know it with your head, believe it with your heart. And the Bible said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth will speak. In other words, you have to sincerely ask Jesus to forgive you of your sins. Now, I'm going to be calling on everybody to repent. And if you have too much pride to repent, it means you need to repent. I'll be calling on everybody, the musicians will be repenting. The preachers will be repenting. The ushers will be repenting. Hello, everybody, we want you to repent. We're going to take a couple minutes at that point and sincerely ask Jesus to forgive us for ourselves. You for you and me for me. You for you and me for me. And then after that, I'm going to pray a prayer of faith. I'm going to ask God to pour out His Spirit, His victory, and His joy. And at that point, we're going to begin to worship God out loud. Just begin to tell Jesus how we love Him and praise Him in our own words. And when you begin to worship Jesus out loud, Allah Ba'alim, when you begin to do that, the presence of God will come upon you. And the next thing you know, these words will begin to bubble up. They're not going to be Tagalog. They're not going to be English, and they're not going to be Greek for you. Amen. They're not going to be Espanol. Amen. They're going to be words of a language other than what you know. It's just the Bible sign of receiving the Holy Ghost. Are you ready to receive something from the Lord? Would you close your eyes with me and let us begin to repent in the presence of the Lord? Let us begin to, amen, ask God's forgiveness right now. You for you and you me for me. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand.
I'll pray, Lord.
Wash my heart, my mind, and my spirit. Wash my soul and my situation. Let me know the Lord to be for me. Lord Jesus, in my heart, and be now right in the sight of God.
God, you're able to take
the Savior of my heart.
Thank you. Listen to me carefully. Listen to me carefully. Close your eyes and listen to me carefully. Listen to me carefully. The presence of God is here. Now here's what's going to happen. We do not beg God, we believe God. You've asked Jesus to forgive you, He has forgiven you. I'm going to pray a prayer of faith, and then we're going to worship the Lord. And when we do, the presence of God is going to fall. Father, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I come by the authority of the Word of God. I come by the authority of the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. You see the needs that are before you, Jesus. And you said in John 14:14, and I pray by that promise, that if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Lord, you see every heart and every need in every situation. Lord, I pray everything and anything that would hinder your refuge in the name of Jesus. And I pray right now by the authority of the blood of Jesus, pour out your Holy Spirit, pour out an anointing of peace and joy and victory in the name of Jesus. I want you to lift your hands right now and begin to praise the Lord. Forget about everybody else. Alaba adios, alaba adios. Look at somebody, lift up your hands and begin to receive the Holy Ghost. Receive joy. Receive your victory. Altar workers, help me and begin to pray with people. Somebody lift up your hands and worship the Lord. Somebody let everything that has breath praise ye the Lord. He's great and greatly to be
for the first time. In other words, you received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, you spoke with other tongues for the first time. In other words, in language, words of a language you don't know. Lift your hand if that's you. Lift your hand if that's you. Amen. You already had it. You too got the Holy Ghost. Come on up here. Come on. Step on up. You. Come on. Whoa! Step on up. Did you get the Holy Spirit? Not yet, but you're going to. You're going to. You're going to get the Holy Spirit. Because if God loves you as much as he does them, did anybody else speak with other tongues for the first time?
There's another girl right here. I don't know if she had it already. She was talking in tongues.
Let's give the Lord a big hand clap of praise for these two. Now listen to me, you two. Go back. If you're here, and God gave you a renewing of the Holy Spirit. In other words, you put more gas in the tank. I want you to lift your hand right now, quickly. Hold your hand if that's you. I know it was you. You're knocking everybody down. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Not like me.
Hallelujah.
Now, we're not done yet. Don't leave. We're almost, but not yet. Look at your neighbor and tell them, church looks good on you. Now here's what's going to happen. We're going to praise the Lord in just a moment again. And what I want you to do is forget about everybody else's. And during this time, I just want you to do like that lady. Just be happy. Amen. Begin. Now if you've not been baptized in Jesus' name, have you been baptized in Jesus' name yet? Oh, we need to get that done. But not you. We've got to get you baptized. You don't want me to chase you. You got to get me baptized. Amen. Got to get baptized. Hey, we got one of these baptized in Jesus' name. They'll work it out for you. Talk to her. You know about it. Yeah, she'll tell you. Okay? So, amen. We're gonna pray again. We're going to take a few more moments. Close your eyes with me. Would you do that? Close your eyes with me. And when you close your eyes, we're not going to beg God. Just close your eyes. You know what we're going to do? Just lift up your hands and receive from the Lord. Would you do that? Come on, somebody. Just lift up your hands and open your mouth and don't beg him, but tell him how you love him. Tell him how you love him. Receive. The Lord is here. If you need a healing in your body, would you lift your hand right now quickly? We're going to pray the prayer of faith. Father, we come by the authority of the Word of God. We come by the authority of the promise of Jesus Christ that if you ask anything in my name, I will do it. In the name of Jesus, we pray, Lord, rebuke every sickness and the root of it in the name of Jesus. I pray right now and release an anointing of the Holy Spirit and will bring about healing. In the name of Jesus, we declare be healed. In the name, cancer be gone in the name of Jesus. Kidney problems be gone in the name of Jesus. Tumors be gone in the name of Jesus. Amen. And depression be gone in the name of Jesus. Let me heal in the name of Jesus. Let our problem be gone in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Will somebody give the Lord a big hand clap of praise? Now just stay right where you're at. We're almost there. Amen. Listen to me carefully. When you want to receive from God, don't beg God. Believe God. You understand? If I'm trying to give you 100 euros, you don't have to beg me for it. You just have to believe me and receive it. You understand? I'm already wanting to give it to you. God's already wanting to give you forgiveness, wanting to give you the baptism of the Holy Spirit, wanting to give you healing and victory. So when you beg Him, He's like, don't you believe me? I'm already trying to help. Don't beg Him, believe Him and receive it. Begging is the opposite of believing. Because of Jesus Christ and His sacrifice, the death, burial, and resurrection, you have a right to receive forgiveness and victory and joy and healing and the Holy Spirit. Can you say amen? Amen. You have a right. And so, close your eyes with me again. We really are about done. Now, be honest before God. If you lie, you fry. If you lie, you fry. I always say that. Close your eyes. I don't need you to build my faith and make me feel good. Okay? Well, I need grace. There are going to be a lot of people here. I mean, there are going to be a lot of people here. There are going to be some notable miracles. Hallelujah. There are going to be a lot more than the Holy Ghost, I believe. Close your eyes. Everybody but Missionary Strickland, I want him to count. If you're here, there's two ways God heals you. There's the working of miracles. That's where the blinded eyes open, the lame walk. There's the gifts of healing. That's where a broken leg normally takes 6 weeks to be normal, to be healed. But God touches it, 1 week later they're back to normal. It's the gifts of healing. If you know, again, if you lie, you fry. Be honest before God. Nobody's looking but Jesus, me, and Missionary Strickland. If you know the Lord has touched you in a healing way today, in a physical healing way, I want you to lift your hand right now quickly. Hold it in the air. If you know, don't look around. Just hold your hand in the air. Some over here too. You count them, Missionary Strickland. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Just another moment. There's a lot of you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Six people said the Lord touched them in a physical healing way. Let's give the Lord a big hand clap of praise. Now here's what you do, those of you that raised your hand, that God physically, as a testimony that God touched you physically for healing. You thank God for the 30, the 40, the 50, the 60, the 70% better that you are. And He will finish that work. And so next Sunday you'll come back and you'll tell us how He's finished the work. Can you say amen? Amen. Now, if anybody, and I got to where I asked this, did anybody have a notable miracle like a tumor fell, a growth disappeared, a tumor disappeared, your eyesight was restored? Amen. Anybody have a notable miracle? I know we don't have any lame walk because you all walked in. Amen. Anybody have a notable miracle today? We're going to see some before I leave. We're going to see some before I leave, and I got one more week. Somebody give the Lord a big hand clap of praise. Now, I'm getting ready to wrap it up, but I want to mention a few things to you, okay? And one, Missionary Strickland wanted me to tell you, everyone who brings a guest next Sunday will get a souvenir gift from Israel. So if you want a gift,
mom's got money.
He said his wife's got the money. So everyone, you bring a guest next Sunday and I'll be here preaching. And you know what happens? You get a gift from Israel. Somebody say amen. Now, I want to mention. Well, boy, it's getting better. Not only do you get a gift for bringing them, but the guest you bring gets a gift from Israel. Somebody say amen. That's really wonderful. That's very good.
Come get a souvenir.
Come get a souvenir, he said. Amen. So bring him next Sunday. Now here's another thing I want to mention to you. How many of you are going with Israel with me Monday? I know that Sister Mercedes is, right? How could you forget a name called Mercedes? Amen. Hey, no wonder you're happy. Amen. If you're going to Israel, I need you to hang around because we're going to have a little meeting at what time?
Yes.
We're going to have a meeting in just a few minutes, okay? And I'm going to go over some things you absolutely need to know because you don't want to miss your flight tomorrow. Hello. You don't want to bring the wrong stuff and leave here the right stuff. So that right after church, you go to the office, and you give me time to shake hands and kiss babies and do all that stuff I do. And I go straight to the office when we're done because I'm coming in there with him. Make sure he turns on the air conditioner. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Hey, I want you to remember.
Oh, hallelujah. What a great day. What a great day. What a great day. Clap your hands over there. Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Now, listen up here. How many's gonna bring somebody with them next Sunday? Are y'all listening? Hello? How many is gonna be here next Sunday? Are you coming next Sunday? Everybody, there's no reason why everybody can't come next Sunday. But if you bring a guest, we're going to give you something from Israel. Maybe a little bottle of water from the Jordan River. Something like that. It may not be a very expensive gift, but it will be from Israel. I want to say one more thing about Brother Brian. He's a good man. He's a jolly fellow. We love him. And I'm just going to tell you how it is. He lives by faith. What's the matter? Job. He's not like Donald Trump. He doesn't have a big business somewhere to pay. He doesn't have a manufacturing company that's working.